Hi, Earth Signs. Thank you for visiting my channel, or thank you for enjoying your sweetest moments with me, Merging Timelines. I am in the process of developing my channel. It has been at least 2 years, hence my lack of consistency. Yeah, it's real. But we're going to continue to work on it and allow you to witness my growth, okay? I read for the sun and moon placement. So if you have an earth sign in sun and moon, this message is to offer you truth and clarity. My earth signs would be my Virgos, my Capricorns, and Taurus. Thank you again for watching. Thank you again for allowing me to be a clear and open channel for your divine messages. I pray that you continue to watch and allow me to give you your divine messages. I'm going to read what just blew out. It's not the way I read the first time, but I just go with the flow, guys. I go with the flow. I lack consistency. I did say that, right? So I'm more so a wing it type of person. If it feels right, it's right. All right, so, and I'm getting these messages pretty quick for us. So this is great. This is great. I'm going to put this down. So for those of you who need, like to see the cards fly out, you can do so for your own peace of mind. Whoa, that one just really flew out. And then you have your last card, which is your advice card that I want to get. This reading's going a little differently, I have to say, than my water sign reading if you just came out of that one. I don't know why. Why my patterns can never be the same. I'm genuinely just really going to start embracing the fact that I just wing a lot of things. I wing it, guys. I wing it. So it shows me that in your recent distant past, the sun coming up in your environment would say that you put a lot of things on hold. Maybe you didn't think that you did, you didn't realize that you did, but I see a lot of your happiness on a very standstill moment right now. And it's because you rejected some sort of emotional offer, right? So maybe in your feelings, you'd say, Mel, this is just not balanced. This love offer that you think that I should be able to accept, yeah, think again. There's so many reasons why I could tell you that it's just not fair. There's so many reasons why I can tell you that try again. Because there's some things that I feel are not balanced. So my Taurus, Capricorn, Virgos feel like something is imbalanced when it comes to their emotions, or this emotional offer that was presented to them could be by a Leo, right? This could be a Leo rising, or I do read just for sun and moon, so I would just stick with they have a Leo moon or a Leo sun. And so there's this new passionate opportunity that this person wants to give to you, but based off of your feelings, I don't feel like you're going to accept them. I don't feel like you're going to accept their offer at this time. You're feeling as though you want to block. Here it is, the Seven of Wands coming up as your influence. You're naturally blocking this person. You are naturally saying, nope, think again, I'd rather go with this big hoo-ha, you know, like this person has a, you know, a lot more bag, a lot more in their package or something. Like you're using a very sexual creative energy to reject an emotional offer, right? It was something in the past that you would have deemed to be a dream come true, but since your experience with it, you would now say, think again, Mel, like that's not the dream. That's not the dream, Mel. So all right, respect. Ten of Wands comes out, and the Ten of Wands tells me that you're going to try your very best, or you should at least, try your very best to lay down a lot of disappointment that you've experienced in your life, possibly with this person. I would have to say it's definitely with this person. This person let you down so many times that you just, hell no, Mel. Where's option two, please? Option two, please. There isn't one, just in case you're wondering. There's growing or healing, growing or healing. So you pick one or two. I almost feel like, remember when you're in that, if you go and get your eyes tested, right, and they go, which one looks better, one or two? One or two? Like, I just thought of that, guys. I really just thought of that. Okay, so anyways, let's go ahead and get some clarification for this spread that I have here for my earth signs that will be coming to this channel that would give me their time. It's appreciated more than I could ever truly express. Let's talk about it, guys, because I'm going to cut this deck and get the energy, the overall energy at the bottom of the deck. I get so triggered by the amount of times I say one word in less than 30 seconds. Oh, like really, Melanie, fix your life. Fix your life! Okay, here we go. Cutting the deck, guys. Well, you know what? I feel like I want to shuffle some more. Feel like I want to like shuffle three times. One. Two. Three. Three. One more, because that was just off. I'm a person who goes with the feels. Gotta go with the feels, guys. All right. So, one, two, three, and four. There's some big message on foundation, structure, consistency. Ooh, I hate that word. Never say hate, guys. Don't follow me. All right, so bottom of the deck, you are doing research. Mel, research. I'm doing my investigation. I'm going within. I'm not going to react. I'm going to withdraw, Mel. Hashtag Infinity Waters. If you haven't watched his channel, please do so. Please do so. So I wonder, what is this that you're doing your research? And I mean, when I talk about research, you're not picking up a book. And this is strange for you, my earth sign, because if I felt like an earth sign was going to try to expand their mind, it's definitely in the form of some sort of tangible item, whether that's a newspaper, a magazine, book, something that has to be real. It has to be something you can hold. Don't feed me the Peter Pan shit today, Mel. You got it. So you're thinking about someone in a distance, and you holding it and thinking, oh, I wish I could be there. Oh, how I wish I could be there in your past. It's something in the past that you just put off. You put this, your own passion, your own thing that you're very passionate about, you put it in delay. Either I feel like there's a woman waiting here, or I feel like you're waiting, But there's definitely a woman in the picture, so I'm gonna go with the picture, guys. And think that you need to travel to this person, because if you can see, there is a map, big emphasis on travel. Don't tell me this card is not about traveling, okay? So if you're thinking about someone, they live at a distance from you, somewhere you have to travel to. In your heart, you feel like something's imbalanced, but the only thing that was imbalanced, my fair earth sign viewer, is that you haven't stepped into your light energy. I think that you're still in the dark side of your energy. Have no fear. We have both within ourselves. I feel like you're more so in the self-seeking, what can I gain out of this partnership? And if you're going to think that way, then things aren't going to quite seem balanced. You might think, hey, I've got such and such, and this person's got such and such. Doesn't quite add up to me, Mel. No. Okay, so let me tell you that the things that you are truly meant to align to aren't going to be made known in the physical. Good luck with that, okay? Whoa, and here we go, talking about the Two of Cups. So I did say you did block this person. Here it is right here. If you don't believe me, if you don't believe me, and you still won't believe me, but it's cool. I'm here for it. I'm here for all of it. You blocked the person that you are divinely connected to. Shame on you. Okay? And so it's because you refuse to juggle. You're like, Mel, this person doesn't even come up on my radar. They don't even come up on my mind. I hate to tell you, because you believe you're a know-it-all. You know, Mel, you think you know what you're talking to or what you're talking about, but this emotional offer, yeah, happened way, way in the past. Way, way in the past. They're not even on my thoughts right now. Yeah, they're not in your thoughts. Yeah, I'm not even gonna lie. I don't even have a single sword card out here. So you're right, they're not in your thoughts. But they really are blocking this union. This lack of union, should I say, is blocking your creative passion. Mm-hmm. But it's cool because we're not really focused on that right now, Mel. We're only focused on things that can physically meet our level. Like, they really have to stand in the here and now. If I'm holding an A plus on my test, it has to have an A plus plus on its test for me to sit there and recognize it. All right, with your tangible ass. Okay? So, yeah, there you go again. Well, it's a delayed success to you. And what you can earn yourself, though, with that type of attitude is a very passionate beginning. But who's not going to entertain a very passionate beginning, especially when it's that big? You know what I mean? So, let me know how that works out for you. But in the meantime, I'll tell you what the advice is, along with you letting go of your negative experiences with this union that you've blocked, right? There is the wheel. Mm-hmm. And so what the wheel talks about is you honoring a new cycle, is you honoring a new chapter. It's like, okay, so the wheel is things spinning in your favor, but things will only spin in your favor the minute you can let go of the negative experiences that you feel or that you think about this person, right? It's really hard for me to convey fire sign energy because it's action-oriented energy. So I feel like your bone that you're picking with this person that you are somewhat not really thinking, not really feeling about any sort of connection towards, like they're not on your mind at all. I feel like this person lacked so much action that you couldn't put any respect on their name if you wanted to. Like, in your opinion, they didn't take enough action. I don't have any specific sign besides, you can say the Leo, the Libra. I hate calling out signs because people get lost. Oh, they didn't say my sign. It's not my message. The message is in the story, people. It's not in the single Pisces or single Capricorn or single whatever you're waiting for me to say. Okay? It's not there. It's not in there. It's in the entire storyline. If the story doesn't fit, the message isn't for you. Okay? All right, sorry about that. Went from 0 to 100, but hey, I'm back. Let's go ahead and get your spiritual message, your spirit animal, should I say? Spirit animal, please. One for my Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo viewers, Sun and Moon. Thank you so much for enjoying my channel as I've enjoyed the time you've spent with me so far. I really have, guys. I really have. I'm so grateful. I am so grateful that you sat through my very annoying video. You've got the octopus. I wonder what that's about because I haven't really, to be honest, I've never really gotten this one or I don't get this one that much. So let's go ahead and do our little research. We learn something new every day. And let's see, octopus. Okay. All right, so I'm going to read its symbolism here for us. It's charismatic, it's complexity, embodies strategy, sixth sense, resilience, deep running emotions, and creativity. Wow. I knew that was going to be extravaganza, the octopus. All right, so in dreams, you generally embody change, success, dynamism, Jesus. So some of your traits are that you focus, you're very good at focus, intellect, talent, and complexity. What I'm getting from this in the reverse, because if this is what the octopus is good at, then this is what you're lacking, right? you're lacking all of these things where you can act and feel independently, right? And so, and you're lacking the focus independently. You need to see things in order to choose them. Yep, that's what I'm going to go with. Ha ha, got the message. So it's more so, again, we thought, we told you, you're rejecting an offer, of an emotional offer. This hasn't even been communicated to you. Like I said, the only sword that I see on the board is going to be the Libra within that says, I feel there's an imbalance, right? I feel. And those feelings, as I'm pointing out to you, this is a sword energy, right? So this card doesn't even talk about feelings. This card talks about thoughts and what someone may identify as balanced and fair. So based off of what you see, based off of what you think is balanced and fair, fire signs, is what is creating your reality, is what is allowing you to develop a damn good, passionate beginning. Like, sex in this one is great, guys. Business in this is great. It's a good offer, but it's not the end-all be-all, which we're not here for, by the way. But it is more so to allow you to open up to merging both physical and spiritual. Yes, baby, what is that? What do you want, banana? Tell me what you want. No candy in there. There's nothing, baby. There's nothing. You want eggs?
Yeah. Oh, you want to draw? Yeah.
You want to go outside and draw?
Yeah.
All right.
Hey, I'm a peach.
All right, so sorry I got up because I really don't need to keep you much longer. I don't have much else to say. I hope that you enjoyed this message. I hope it offered you some sort of peace and clarity. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop them in the comment box below. I do answer them very quickly. With all that being said, have a great day. Bye.